Hi everybody and welcome to my channel Hobby the BB. Earlier I posted an overview of pneumonia and today I am going to discuss this condition in detail. Well, pneumonia is an infection that inflames the air sacs in one or both lungs. The air sacs may fill with fluid or pus, which is a purulent material, and this causes cough with phlegm or pus, fever, chills and difficulty in breathing. A variety of organisms, including bacteria, viruses, and fungi, can cause pneumonia. Pneumonia can range in seriousness from mild to life-threatening. It is most serious for infants and young children, or people older than age 65, and people with health problems or weakened immune system. Now, I'll tell you the symptoms. The signs and symptoms of pneumonia vary from mild to severe, depending on factors such as the type of germ causing the infection and your age and overall health. Mild signs and symptoms often are similar to those of a cold or flu, but they last longer. Signs and symptoms of pneumonia may include chest pain when you breathe or cough, confusion or changes in mental awareness, especially in adults age 65 and older. You may experience cough which may produce phlegm, or there may be fatigue. Also, there may be fever, sweating and shaking chills. Lower than normal body temperature in adults, especially who are older than age 65 and people with weak immune system. I mean, it's not necessary that you will always have a fever. People who are immunocompromised or older people above 65 may have a lower body temperature. Okay. Also, you may experience nausea, vomiting or diarrhea. There could be shortness of breath. Newborns and infants may not show any signs of infection, or they may vomit, have a fever and cough, or they may appear restless or tired and without energy, or they may have difficulty in breathing and eating. You should see your doctor if you have difficulty in breathing, chest pain, persistent fever of 102 degree Fahrenheit or 39 degree centigrade or higher, or persistent cough, especially if you are coughing up pus. It's especially important that people in these high-risk groups see a doctor, especially those adults older than age 65, children younger than age 2 with signs and symptoms, people with an underlying health condition or weakened immune system, or people who are receiving chemotherapy or taking medication that suppress the immune system. For some older adults and people with heart failure or chronic lung problems, pneumonia can become a life-threatening condition. Now let me tell you the causes of pneumonia. Many germs can cause pneumonia. The most common are bacteria and viruses in the air we breathe. Your body usually prevents these germs from infecting your lungs, but sometimes these germs can overpower your immune system even if your health is generally good. Pneumonia is classified according to the types of germ that cause it and when and where you got the infection. The first and most common is community-acquired pneumonia. Community-acquired pneumonia is the most common type of pneumonia. It occurs outside of hospitals or other healthcare facilities. It may be caused by bacteria. The most common cause of bacterial pneumonia is Streptococcus pneumoniae. This type of pneumonia can occur on its own or after you have had a cold or the flu. It may affect one part or lobe of the lung, which is a condition called lobar pneumonia. Then could be a bacteria-like organism, which is Mycoplasma pneumoniae, that can also cause pneumonia. It typically produces milder symptoms than do other types of pneumonia. Walking pneumonia is an informal name given to this type of pneumonia, which typically is not severe enough to require bed rest. Fungi. This type of pneumonia is most common in people with chronic health problems or weakened immune system, and in people who have inhaled large doses of the organism. The fungi that cause it can be found in soil or bird droppings and vary depending upon geographic location. Viruses, including COVID-19. So this is a pandemic nowadays. So you should be careful, because COVID-19 can also cause pneumonia. Some of the viruses that cause cold and flu can also cause pneumonia. Viruses are the most common cause of pneumonia in children younger than 5 years. Viral pneumonia is usually mild, but in some cases it can become very serious. As I told you before, COVID-19 may cause pneumonia, which can become severe. Another type of pneumonia is hospital-acquired pneumonia. Some people catch pneumonia during a hospital stay for another illness. Hospital acquired pneumonia can be serious because the bacteria causing it may be more resistant to antibiotics and because the people who get it are already sick. People who are in breathing machines, on ventilators, often used in intensive care units are at higher risk of this type of pneumonia. Then another type is healthcare acquired pneumonia. This is a bacterial infection that occurs in people who live in long-term care facilities or who receive care in outpatient clinics, including kidney dialysis centers. Like hospital-acquired pneumonia, healthcare-acquired pneumonia can be caused by bacteria that are more resistant to antibiotics. Then the another type is aspiration pneumonia. This occurs when you inhale food, drink, vomit, or saliva into your lungs. Aspiration is more likely if something disturbs your normal gag reflex, such as a brain injury or swallowing problem or excess use of alcohol or drugs. Now I should tell you the risk factors of pneumonia. Pneumonia can affect anyone, but the two age groups which are at higher risk are children who are 2 years old or younger, or people who are age 65 or older. Other risk factors include being hospitalized. You are at great risk of pneumonia if you are in a hospital intensive care unit, especially if you are on a machine that helps you breathe. If you are on a ventilator, then there is a more risk. Okay. Chronic disease. You are more likely to get pneumonia if you have asthma, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, that is COPD, or heart disease. Smoking. Smoking damages your body's natural defenses against the bacteria and viruses that cause pneumonia. Weakened or suppressed immune system. People who have HIV/AIDS or who have had an organ transplant or who receive chemotherapy or on long-term steroids are at increased risk of pneumonia. Now I should tell you the complications. Even with treatment, some people with pneumonia, especially those in higher risk groups, may experience complications which include bacteremia. Bacteria that enter the bloodstream from your lungs can spread the infection to other organs, potentially causing organ failures. Okay. Difficulty breathing. If your pneumonia is severe or you have chronic underlying lung disease, you may have trouble breathing in enough oxygen. You may need to be hospitalized and use a breathing machine, that is ventilator, while your lung heals. Fluid accumulation around the lungs, that is pleural effusion. Pneumonia may cause fluid to build up in the thin space between layers of tissue that lines the lung and chest cavity, that is pleura, as you can see the images in my video. Please note that my videos are not only important just from the listening point of view, but you should watch it because I usually post videos according to the speech which I'm giving, so that you should understand the illness properly. Okay. So I was talking about pleural effusion. Well, if the fluid becomes infected, you may need to have it drained through a chest tube or removed with surgery. Lung abscess. An abscess occurs if pus forms in a cavity in the lung. An abscess is usually treated with antibiotics. Sometimes surgery or drainage with a long needle or tube placed in the abscess is needed to remove the pus. Okay, these were the complications. Now I'll tell you the preventive measures. You should get vaccinated. Vaccines are available to prevent some types of pneumonia and the flu. Talk with your doctor about getting these shots. The vaccination guidelines have changed over time, so make sure to review your vaccination status with your doctor, even if you recall previously receiving a pneumonia vaccine. Also, make sure that children get vaccinated. Doctors recommend a different pneumonia vaccine for children younger than age 2 and for the children ages 2 to 5 years who are at particular risk of pneumococcal disease. Children who attend a group child care center should also get the vaccine. Doctors also recommend flu shots for children older than 6 months. Practice good hygiene. To protect yourself against respiratory infections that sometimes lead to pneumonia, wash your hands regularly or use an alcohol-based hand sanitizer. Do not smoke. Smoking damages your lung natural defenses against respiratory infections, so there's a more chance of infections such as pneumonia. Okay. Also, you should keep your immune system strong. Get enough sleep, exercise regularly, and eat a healthy diet. Well, on my channel Hubit BP, I have posted a video in which I have discussed the top foods which boost your immunity. You must watch that video. That is a really helpful video. Okay. Now let me tell you the diagnosis of pneumonia. When patients come to us, we start by asking about your medical history and doing a physical exam, which include listening to your lungs with a stethoscope to check for abnormal bubbling or crackling sound that suggests pneumonia. If pneumonia is suspected, your doctor may recommend the other tests, which I should tell you, blood tests. Blood tests are used to confirm an infection and to try to identify the type of organism causing the infection. However, precise identification is not always possible. Chest X-ray. This helps your doctor diagnose pneumonia and determine the extent and location of the infection. However, it cannot tell your doctor what kind of germ is causing the pneumonia. Pulse oximetry. This measures the oxygen level in your blood. Pneumonia can prevent your lungs from moving enough oxygen into your bloodstream. Sputum test. A sample of fluid from your lungs, which is sputum, is taken after a deep cough and analyzed to help pinpoint the cause of infection. Your doctor might also order additional tests if you are older than age 65 or in the hospital or have serious symptoms or health condition. These tests may include CT scan. If your pneumonia is not clearing as quickly as expected, your doctor may recommend a chest CT scan to obtain a more detailed image of your lungs. Pleural fluid culture. A fluid sample is taken by putting a needle between your ribs from the pleural area and analyzed to help determine the type of infection. Now coming to the treatment. Treatment for pneumonia involves curing the infection and preventing complications. People who have community-acquired pneumonia usually can be treated at home with medication. Although most symptoms ease in a few days or weeks, the feeling of tiredness can persist for a month or more. Specific treatment depends on the type and severity of your pneumonia, your age, and your overall health. The options of treatment include antibiotics. These medicines are used to treat bacterial pneumonia. It may take time to identify the type of bacteria causing your pneumonia and to choose the best antibiotic to treat it. If your symptoms do not improve, your doctor may recommend a different antibiotic. Cough medicine. This medicine may be used to calm your cough so that you can rest. Because coughing helps loosen and move fluid from your lungs, it's a good idea not to eliminate your cough completely. In addition, you should know that very few studies have looked at whether over-the-counter cough medications lessen coughing caused by pneumonia. If you want to try a cough suppressant, use the lowest dose that helps you rest. Fever-reducing medicine and pain relievers. You may take these as needed for fever and discomfort. These include drugs such as aspirin, ibuprofen, and acetaminophen, which comes with the name of Tylenol. Also, some patients may need hospitalization, especially if you are older than age 65, or if you are confused about time, people, or places, your kidney function has declined, or if your systolic blood pressure is below 90 mm of mercury, or your diastolic blood pressure is 60 mm of mercury or below. So these are the indications of hospitalization which I'm telling you. And other indications is that if your breathing is rapid, I mean if it is more than 30 breaths or more than this per minute, you need breathe, or if you need breathing assistance, your temperature is below normal. I mean, in some patients, especially in older adults, it's not necessary that they have fever. Their temperature may be below normal. Okay, so in that case also you may be hospitalized. Okay, or if your heart rate is below 50, which is bradycardia, or if it is above 100, that is tachycardia. Okay, you may be admitted to the intensive care unit if you need to be placed on a breathing machine, that is ventilator, or if your symptoms are severe. Children may be hospitalized if they are younger than age 2 months, or if they are lethargic or excessively sleepy, or they have troubled breathing, or they have low blood oxygen level, or they appear dehydrated. Okay, so these are the treatment options which I have just told you. Here I should also tell you about lifestyle and home remedies, which are also very important to listen. Okay. The tips which I am going to tell you can help you recover more quickly and decrease your risk of complications. The first tip is that you should get plenty of rest. Do not go back to school or work until after your temperature returns to normal and you stop coughing up mucus. Even when you start to feel better, be careful not to overdo it, because pneumonia can reoccur. It's better not to jump back into your routine until you are fully recovered. Ask your doctor if you are not sure. You should stay hydrated. drink plenty of fluids, especially water, to help loosen mucus in your lungs. Okay, you should take your medicine as prescribed. Take the entire course of any medication your doctor prescribed for you. If you stop taking medication too soon, your lungs may continue to harbor bacteria that can multiply and cause your pneumonia to reoccur. So this was my video about pneumonia. I hope you have watched this video very, very carefully. If you suffer from any illness, please do not forget to post comment, and I'll try to make a video about your illness. And if I do not find it time, I'll try to reply to your comment as soon as possible, because I replied to almost every comment on my channel. Okay, and till now, if you haven't subscribed my channel, please subscribe it and click the bell icon so that all upcoming videos are delivered to your inbox straight away. And if you think that my videos provide some sort of benefit, even if it is a little bit benefit, please give a thumbs up to this video, because that will give me an encouragement to make more useful videos such as this one. And also, do not forget to share my videos to others, especially through social media such as Facebook and Twitter, because this channel of mine, Hubez BB, is basically created to help humanity across the world. So by sharing my videos to others, you will be also part of this great initiative. Thank you so much for watching this video. See you in next video. Bye for now.